Hi there, my name's Dan, and you're about to learn how to draw perfect curves in Adobe Illustrator. And no, we're not using the pen tool, but we will be using a tool that I think many designers just completely ignore. At least I did for many years, because I'm a complete and utter lemon. And in the next few minutes, you'll understand exactly why this tool is so essential, especially when it comes to shapes and getting those beautifully smooth curves. This video is also sponsored by Squarespace, which is an awesome all-in-one website building platform. And first, we need to set up a must-have shortcut that is going to save us a ton of time. So you can see I'm in Illustrator and I have a pixelated squiggle on screen. Don't worry, we'll come back to that in a second. First of all, we need to go to Edit and down to Keyboard Shortcuts. And from the box here, we're going to type Curve, and this will be the Curvature tool. And let's select that. Your shortcut may be different here. I've set mine to Shift-P, which is nice and easy to remember. Save any changes, and now we've got P for the pen tool, Shift-P for the curvature tool. And you can see it over here in the toolbar on the left. Right, now that's done, let's check out the fast and lazy method. So coming back to said squiggle, what we can do is we can just click, click, click. And whereas the normal pen tool will draw straight lines, this will draw curved lines. And this isn't the most ideal way to use this tool, but as you can see, it does work. So let's just quickly click, click, click all the way around the edge of this squiggle. Click, click, muck, clicky, click. There we go, all done. And let's just thicken that up so you can see what we've created. There we go, we have a squiggly line. As you can see, it's not perfect, but one thing you can do is go to Object, and then down to Path, and let's go and select Smooth. I love this feature. We get a nice little slider here, and we can just crank this up a little bit, and all those jaggedy bits, they just get smoothed out. Now let's take a look at the better and easier method, and I'll explain how this tool works. Okay, so to many of you, this logo may look familiar. We have the old Twitter logo, or X, or whatever the heck it's called now. Nobody knows. And I have the curvature tool selected. And what I'm gonna do is identify every single curve here. So what I'm gonna do is start with this one. And I'm gonna click and define a starting point. And you can see I've got a curve here. There we go. And that will be my end point. And then this is going to be my midpoint. So start point, midpoint, and end point. Very important to remember those. So I'm just gonna single click on the start point, hold Alt or Option. This will enable me to draw a straight line. We'll define the midpoint, and we'll keep that held and define the end point. Now you don't have to hold down Alt or Option, but I'll show you why in a minute, because it just makes things so much easier. But before we move on to the next step, well, firstly, hello, I'm Future Dan in the new purpley room, and this video is sponsored by Squarespace. And what is Squarespace? Well, it's an awesome all-in-one platform that is perfect for creatives, entrepreneurs, and business owners, because Squarespace has all the tools you'll need in one place. Plus, as well as quickly setting up a fantastic looking website, you can sell physical or digital products through an online store, and can also take payments through services like Apple Pay and PayPal, which is, well, just handy for everyone. There's also plenty of website templates that are fully responsive, so you don't have to worry about whether or not it's going to work on mobile. And my favorite feature is definitely their blueprint and SEO tools. And this is kind of like a guided design system, and it enables you to create a professional looking site that is completely unique and built from the ground up, whilst also being optimized for SEO. So if you're interested, check out squarespace.com to get started with a free trial. And when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/Dansky to save 10% off your first website or domain. So thanks again to Squarespace for sponsoring this video. Now, back to it. So now we're gonna go to the next curve here. Remember, I'm still holding Alt or Option. So this is my next curve here. So I've got my start point already defined. Click on the midpoint, click on the end point. And you need to do this no matter how small and insignificant the curves may seem. Click on the midpoint, click on the end point. You may be starting to see a pattern here. Right, let's just go through this nice and quick. And as you can see, well, that is terrible. But don't worry, we can fix this. Select everything, curvature tool. Now we can see these curvature tool specific nodes. And what we're going to do is we're going to double click on all of the midpoints. So let's start with this one here. Double click. Voila, you can see that it curves everything between the start and the end point perfectly. Let's do the same again. Double click a midpoint. Double click a midpoint. Double click. And we'll do this all the way around, just double clicking on those midpoints. And as you can see, it isn't perfect, but what we can do is we can grab these points by selecting them and we can actually move them around. So I could kind of bring that belly a little bit lower there. If you want to as well, you can actually click to add more points like this. Whoa, hey, let's go over here. No, don't do that. And then we can delete points as well with them selected by just pressing delete. And the great thing about this is it makes it very difficult to get bad curves, because as I adjust this one point, you can see all of the other curves connected to it, they also adjust as well. Lastly, let's put this tool and these techniques to the test by drawing a shape that I've always found rather challenging, and that is fire.
Fire.
So again, I've got my curvature tool selected, and I'm going to start down here. And I'm going to do this holding Alt or Option. You don't have to. You can just click and click, and then you come and get the curve straight away. Let's click there, click there. We're going to click there and there. The curve kind of changes here, so we're going to go midpoint, endpoint. So let's just go around and double click on those midpoints. There's one, two, yep, you, you, and you. Double click there. Yeah, there we go. Right, let's thicken up that stroke. Nice. Right, what I'm going to do as well is I'm going to round off the cap and corner so everything's nice and rounded. There we go. Right, as you can see, that's not perfect. We've made a few oopsies there. So let's zoom in and then grab the curvature tool with that handy keyboard shortcut that we did earlier. And let's click on this point here. And I can move this around in real time, and I can kind of move this around. And the great thing is I can actually use this to define a really smooth curve. So I can see that that looks pretty good now. Maybe I'll grab this bottom one and just move that around, and then this one here, I might bring that up, or instead maybe bring this one a bit lower just so I get a nice smooth kind of bowl shape. If I zoom back out, I think, yeah, that looks pretty good. And we can swap that fill and stroke. Yeah, get a good look at the end result. And as I say, you can go and refine this a lot further, but this is a great starting point for tackling challenging curves. So there we go. That is the video. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Take care, and I'll see you next time.